show we have scheduled here tonight in Las Vegas, Nevada, in Sin City, as we've got a tremendous main event set here tonight as we are starting the qualifiers for the Ring Warriors Tournament. Yes, the qualifiers will be the matches to determine who will get in the Ring Warriors Tournament that will happen over the next couple weeks up until the Royal Rumble, and then following the Royal Rumble, of course, leading up to the Ring Warriors pay-per-view, we will have the Ring Warriors Tournament take place. Those eight superstars that win their qualifying match up until Royal Rumble, they'll get a spot. And of course, this man right here, the phenomenal AJ Styles, got an auto qualify. He was the first one to qualify for this year's Ring Warriors. He was the first one to qualify for a qualifying match simply due to the fact that he won last year's Ring Warriors Tournament. And apparently, according to the owner, the rest of them were picked randomly out of random selection. AJ Styles just got accepted on automatically. But this is not his match. His match is next week. He's going one-on-one with Kevin Owens, right, I do believe? No, not Kevin Owens. Mark Briscoe, my bad. On SmackDown, though, I do believe, on next week's SmackDown. But here tonight, AJ Styles has a tremendous task set ahead of him as he's to go one-on-one with Freeze. AJ Styles has been kicking off Raw the past couple weeks, and you could say not so impressive fashion. Lost both of his matches so far. He hasn't got a win yet on Raw, but I'm not going to bash him for it because of the fact that his first match, he went one-on-one with Nitro, of all people. And the next one, he had a very tough opponent as well. AJ Styles has been going up against the top of the freaking food chain here on Raw, which is very gutsy of Styles and is making him look bad as of late, but I don't think you could count him out at any moment in time. But he's going up against this man, this dangerous, this deranged man known as Freeze, who's taking out Kevin Owens and Samoa Joe, as well as Jack Swagger over the past couple weeks. And I'm messing up bad here tonight. Things are getting heated up. We got a new Universe Champion. We come to find out why we haven't seen Chief Graham in the past few weeks. Of course, the owner gave Chief Graham an unpaid vacation. So we'll see when Chief Graham gets back. I'm sure he's going to have something to say to the owner. Where the hell he's at right now. Maybe the Bahamas. Big head kick. Maybe back with those Navajo natives. I don't freaking know where Chief Graham's at right now. He was sent on an unpaid vacation. Freaking asshole. And of course, we know that both members of the Order are in qualifying matches. I wonder how that got set up. Big drop kick there from Styles, as well as other various superstars like NXT's Delson Hollow and Finn Balor. Or SmackDown's Miz. Shot to the leg there. Miz and, of course, Miz and MVP. We're going to have some very interesting matchups here. And nothing necessarily says they have to be on their own brand. Just like I said, AJ Styles the following week will be going one-on-one with, went for a baseball slide. He was going to slide out the ring, it looked like. Decided not to because Freeze got back in the ring. No, AJ Styles will be going one-on-one with one half of the Briscoes, that being Mark Briscoe. Should be an interesting matchup, first time ever matchup. Oh, now Freeze. Nice arm lock lariat there. Of course, the new Universe Champion, Leon Blackgrave, will be in the main event tonight. He'll be competing in his qualifier against Zack Ryder, the Long Island IZ, the man who came in second last year during the Ring Warriors Tournament, which of course would end up costing him. He wouldn't get a spot at the Mania card, which this Ring Warriors Tournament is huge. The freaking tournament, the winner of the tournament gets a guaranteed spot on the WrestleMania card, which is the biggest pay-per-view of the universe, obviously, each year. And it guarantees you a spot on that card. So winning that is a must. And last year, it's usually almost always gold involved. Last year, AJ Styles was involved in the six-man battle royal for Seth freaking Rollins NXT Championship. because of that, the rest of the people that were in it had to qualify in matches. AJ Styles got a free pass into that Battle Royal because of the fact that he won the Ring Warriors tournament, and he was showcased at WrestleMania. It's a huge opportunity for whoever wins the Ring Warriors tournament, as well as the Royal Rumble, which we've come to find out due to the fact that Aztec and Draven Cross are both on the shelf now. The owner is going to make the freaking Royal Rumble match for the television championship. Oh, now AJ, phenomenal forearm from AJ Styles. That could be it. He could pin him there if he wanted to, but he's not going to. Oh, God, AJ now. Springboard 450. Oh, he overshot it, though. AJ Styles, oh, the momentum, the hype from the crowd getting the best of him there, and he overshot the damn 450. Oh. Nice suplex there from the phenomenal one. He already hit him with a phenomenal forearm. I don't know what the hell else AJ's going to have to hit him with for Freeze to stay the fuck down. Oh, I think AJ's going for a Pele there. Freeze going to stop him. Freeze is going to cut him off. No Pele kick for you. Now Freeze is going to put the work in on the arm of the phenomenal one. Like I said, AJ already throwing in that phenomenal forearm into play. Needs to look to get out of this damn arm hold here from Freeze. Freeze is just wearing down the arm of AJ Styles, taking out the limb of the phenomenal one. It's just not very phenomenal for AJ Styles in his future here in the universe on Raw. Oh, now Freeze sends Styles into the corner. Oh, God, Styles don't want none of this. Oh, Jesus, come on. Come on, Freeze, not this. Oh, muscle buster from Freeze. He did that to Samoa Joe 8 times in a row. Well, not in a row, but consecutively in one match. And then 2 ice picks, too, and Samoa Joe's been out of action ever since, too. Styles kicks out that muscle buster. AJ needs to be careful right now because Freeze was targeting that arm earlier. Now he's targeting the shoulder. AJ's got to be careful now. AJ snaps down Freeze. Oh, and now AJ going to look to wear down Freeze. Freeze, I mean, he has a lot of fans, but he also has a lot of people that hate him. I mean, which I can see it either way. I mean, some people I've even heard call him the freaking human popsicle, which I think would be a little antagonizing if I was Freeze, and a little aggravating to say the least. Oh, and maybe that's what fuels his anger here to take out people with that goddamn ice pick. And the fact that people keep underestimating him, and right there, Eye of the Blizzard. You can't underestimate Freeze, and I think if anyone knows that, it should be AJ Styles. He's learned that you can't underestimate anyone on Raw. And Styles is able to kick out there too, out of the Eye of the Blizzard. And I'm not talking about the ones you get at Dairy Queen either. This isn't no frozen treat. That's a fucking treat for Freeze maybe in his mind, and not for AJ Styles. Oh, Styles went for a forearm. Freeze is going to counter deliver one of his own to the phenomenal one. Now Freeze once again going to snap down AJ Styles and look to put the work to him again. Oh, but AJ counters him off. Elbow right to the goddamn temple. Oh, now Styles with control on Freeze. What is he doing? He's going to sweep him down. Oh, knees to the leg of Freeze. Of course, you know, going to set up for that. The calf killer. 2. And Freeze, of course, forced to kick out with that bad leg. Oh, and then a kick to the back, or not necessarily bad, but the one that just got targeted. Oh, and now Styles kicking him in the back again. AJ's had enough. He just was punking Freeze there. Gonna kick him in the back twice. It's kind of insulting. Oh, now Styles gonna send Freeze off the ropes and go through. German suplex from the phenomenal one. This has been a good bout back and forth. Freeze looking to get back in that title contendership. Did not secure a place in the Ring Warriors tournament, or a qualifier to get in the tournament, I should say. Remember, 16 people have the chance to qualify. These matches that you're going to see over the next couple weeks are qualifying matches just to get into the tournament. And after that, those 8 men that go on into the tournament will have to compete against one another and freeze their escapes out of that position. That was a very bad position there for AJ, or for Freeze. Oh, one that you don't necessarily want to be in ever. Oh, God. And now Freeze. Freeze is hooking him up. Freeze is hooking him up. You know what this is? This is the Frostbite submission hold. Targeting the legs of AJ Styles. And that can be it. 1, 2. AJ kicks out of the freaking Frostbite. Freeze has so many variations of that Frostbite. One that he lays down into it, which is going to apply more pressure to a different part of the leg. And then he's got that one. And then he also has another inverted version, all of which is going to apply pressure to different parts of the tendon of that leg, which really Freeze is looking to tear up your whole goddamn leg, not just one part. That's why he uses it in variations all the time. Of course, that's not the only submission Freeze packs. Unlike AJ Styles, Freeze has multiple submission holds. Oh! There's no submissions about that. AJ Styles is going to tap out of that. He might pass out, but AJ gets right back up after that back superplex. Holy shit. And now Freeze has had enough. He's going for a T-bone. AJ Styles counters with a hatch. And now Styles is just stalking Freeze, waiting for him to get back up to his feet. Oh, and now Styles with a counter to Freeze again. Oh, and now Styles spins him around. What is he doing here? Oh, God, half hatch. Oh, backbreaker, knee to the spine of Freeze. Now that's got to rearrange the vertebrae there. And now AJ Styles lifting up Freeze. Oh, Pele kick. We've seen the phenomenal forearm earlier. Now a Pele from the phenomenal one. 1, 2. Oh, Styles trying to get back on track, but Freeze is not going to get derailed either. Oh, went for the body shot. Styles was able to catch that shot, though, and whip him into the corner. And now AJ appears to be taking Freeze to the top. Maybe going to give something back to Freeze. Oh, geez, and that it is. Oh, geez, but Styles going to the very top here. Oh, Jesus. Both these guys, their backs have got to be hurting after that. Off the very top. Off the top, down below to the mat. 1, 2. Freeze kicks out again. These guys are beating the shit out of each other. And once again, everyone is on their feet here tonight. Things are getting really heated up as we get close to the Royal Rumble. And to find out that the Royal Rumble is going to be for the television championship, Aztec's vacated TV championship too, I might add, thanks to Pentagon Jr., who hopefully we'll see on SmackDown, maybe get some action out of him or some answers or something. But Freeze right here is going for another one of these muscle busters. Oh my God, and now Freeze is not wasting any time. He lifts him back up. Oh, please, come on. You have got to be kidding me. That was the second muscle buster of the match. And now it appears Freeze might be going for a third. Gotta be kidding me. Freeze likes his muscle busters like Randy Orton likes his goddamn superplexes. 3 at once. Oh, Jesus. Oh, see what I said? Freeze is not wasting any time. Looking to make a statement here at the hands of the phenomenal one. Oh wait, no, he's taking him up to the top backwards this time. This could be even worse for Styles. Oh, worse for wear maybe, but AJ Styles able to counter. Missile drop kick off the top from the phenomenal one. And now AJ is starting to get cocky here. He's starting to gloat a little, which is not smart, but I think AJ's got Freeze right where he wants him. It's what it appears. Oh, kick to the stomach. Oh my God, he's going for the clash. The clash, Styles clash. Roll over into the cover. 1, 2, 3. And AJ Styles finally picks up a win here tonight on Raw. Oh, and Freeze does not look none too happy. But AJ Styles gets the better of Freeze here tonight. what AJ needed. He needed momentum going into his Ring Warriors match. Last year, if you remember, this was around when AJ really started to branch out and grow as a superstar. And that's where he won the Ring Warriors tournament. Of course, this Ring Warriors tournament, if you don't remember, every single match after they actually qualify, the 8 superstars, their matches inside this tournament will be under random stipulation, meaning they will not know what type of match they're going into until the bell has rung. The referee will tell them once they get in the ring, but up until that point, they have no freaking clue of what type of match they will be going into, which is the problem, because that causes a huge key factor in the mindset of the superstars going into it. They have no fucking clue what to expect. It could be a ladder match, it could be a TLC match, it could be a last man standing match. You might not even have to pin someone to win the damn match. That's how interesting this could be. The damn finals of last year's was Zack Ryder and AJ Styles in a ladder match. They had to pull out a briefcase with the contract of a WrestleMania spot in the balance. That's how they won last year's. This year's, it could be in a cell, it could be by escaping a cage, it could be by putting your opponent through a table, for God's sake. I hope not, because Raw freaking needs no more broken announce tables. But nonetheless, AJ Styles picks up a big victory here to kick off Raw. Going from one person who's relatively new to Raw to another two, we're going to have Gold Money Gregory Murphy back in action. After that huge matchup he had with Leon Blackgrave a couple weeks ago in a freaking no-holds-barred match. That was insane, but Gold Money, it appears, he did not qualify for the Ring Warriors, or he did not earn a qualifying spot for the Ring Warriors tournament, but he did get himself a spot on the Raw roster, so I mean, I would take that if I were him. That's pretty nice. His opponent, though, here tonight, Kevin Owens, did, however, get a spot to qualify for the tournament. And of course, his match is not tonight. Tonight we have one match on Raw. The main event is a qualifier. Then on NXT and SmackDown this week, they both have 2 qualifying matches on their shows. And then the following week, up until Royal Rumble, the rest of the shows have 1 qualifier match a night. We're going to get all 8 matches done to decide the 8 superstars that will be in the Ring Warriors tournament for the big Ring Warriors pay-per-view that will main event the pay-per-view. It's a huge stipulation as we just creep in towards WrestleMania, just 2 pay-per-views before Mania. And now here comes the man who's looking to challenge Gregory Murphy here tonight, but will challenge the Lunatic Fringe, Dean Ambrose, tomorrow night on NXT to see if he will qualify into the Ring Warriors tournament. This is going to be huge. Of course, like I said, the tournament, unlike the previous years, the whole tournament was at the Ring Warriors pay-per-view. This year, we're deciding to book other matches at the Ring Warriors pay-per-view, and the whole tournament will lead up to Ring Warriors throughout the weeks. And then the final two will compete in the main event of Ring Warriors to decide who will go on to compete at WrestleMania for a belt, whatever belt that may be. Well, I should say more than likely there'll be gold on the line. There always has been, so I'm not going to expect anything to change. Oh, and Gold Money immediately going after Kevin Owens. Oh, that's kind of insulting there. He just threw him to the outside. I mean, Gold Money's wanting to make a statement, though, here. Oh, he is part of Team ACWF back in Survivor Series. No, just over a month ago, and Gold Money's got to be irate after having to go one-on-one with Leon Blackgrave. And Blackgrave gave him a beating, man. In all fairness, Leon Blackgrave is now your Universe Champion, though. Oh, very legit superstar, which you already knew that. Former TV champion as well, not that that title matters much right now, considering the fact that Aztec couldn't hold on to it either for more than a month. Oh, and now Kevin Owens took a bunch of shit from Gold Money at the starting. Owens is now going to look to dish out and deliver to Gold Money. Oh, and he throws Gold Money into the damn barricade. Oh God, oh God. Oh, sidewalk slam on the outside. These guys are getting vicious, which you've got to think that's got to be in the wheelhouse of Kevin Owens or the warehouse, but whatever. It's got to be right and out of Kevin Owens' playbook here, or his hopes anyways, because he's going up against the Lunatic Fringe, Dean Ambrose, to qualify into the tournament. Which that's going to be a tough bout for Kevin Owens. We'll have to see who can walk out with the victory, though. Oh, huge mash move there from Gold Money. Holy shit. Greg Murphy there with an impressive maneuver. Oh, and that's not so impressive from Kevin Owens, just an eye rake. But man, guys, Aftershock was insane. We got a new Universe Champion. Oh, that really felt like the actual earthquake. Not the Aftershock of Survivor Series to me. Adam Page is now kicked out of the connection thanks to him taking a loss to GMT. Great performance, though, by both superstars. And Adam Page's hand was under the ropes, too. The ref did not catch it, though. Adam Page getting screwed over by the ropes in that match. One. Without that rope screwing him over, who knows, maybe he could have won it. But frankly, at the end of the day, he did not kick out of the GDT. Therefore, GMT goes on. He defeats Adam Page. Adam Page is no longer part of the connection, according to Chris Benoit. And then we've got to think of the big main event that we're going to have at Royal Rumble. The Viper, the Apex Predator, the sadistic son of a bitch that is Randy Orton, going one-on-one with the Crippler, the Rabid Wolverine, the current Intercontinental Champion, the leader of the connection, Chris Benoit, for the Intercontinental Championship, the most prestigious gold, piece of gold in the universe. That is going to be intense. Oh, you got to think maybe the Ring Warriors winner earns a title shot at the IC title. That would be huge. That's how much this freaking tournament's going to mean. And that's why Kevin Owens is really looking for a win here. Kill Owens, kill, is what is being chanted right now from the crowd. Oh, like Kevin Owens with a super kick to Greg Murphy. He had him backed up against the barricade. And guys, this has just been an all-out brawl so far. These guys are beating the hell out of each other. We also seen Undertaker knock off Marcus, but then was revealed to have a new opponent for Royal Rumble, which is going to be none other than the Executioner, Xander Mercer. And what the fuck is Greg Gold Money doing? Oh, drop kicked him in the face first right into the goddamn referee. Can we get some medical out here for the damn referee? Oh, shit. No, oh, big move there from Gold Money. Just planted Kevin Owens. Oh my god, damn it. Now he's going in for the cover. The referee was down. One, two. And thanks to the referee being down, that could have cost him the opportunity to get the win there. Oh man, the referee just got hit hard there. Oh, now Owen's going to send Gold Money into the corner. Oh shit, you know what he's going for, Greg Murphy. Oh, spins him around into a big clothesline. Oh, and now, oh. Very eccentric wrestling style here from Greg Murphy being shown on display. And now Gold Money appears to be going to the top. He's looking for some high risk, high reward, possibly. Or maybe a big failure, but no, he hits that big leap of faith elbow drop. Luckily enough, Kevin Owens wasn't out too far. So Greg Murphy didn't have to jump too far, that is. Oh, big club to the back. Oh, and now another club to the back. Not sure how far Gregory Murphy can jump after that beating that he took with Blackgrave. I'm surprised Greg Murphy is lasting this long with Owens. And now Owens with a counter. Oh, cannonball off the top from KO. Oh my god, he just destroyed Murphy with that, dude. Oh god, and now Owens has him up. Go home, driver. Connects into the cover from Owens. One, two. Murphy kicks out at two. Oh geez, and now Owens. I mean, he could not be an asshole about it, but he just stomps him on the back. Now Murphy counters punch to the stomach. Oh, Murphy's caught him. He's caught him eating defeat. Wait, oh, Owens with a counter kick to the stomach. Oh, and now KO's got Murphy up. He's got him up. Wait, Murphy. Not sure what the hell Owens was doing. Murphy counters with a neck breaker. It looked like he's gonna high cross him into the goddamn turnbuckles. Oh, and now Greg Murphy lifts Kevin Owens up to his feet. Oh, and now Murphy gonna send Owens off the ropes and sleeper slam. Man, none of these guys can be sleeping in this match. Gregory Murphy quickly into a cover. One, two. Owens kicks out at two. These are some insane matches here to kick off Raw. Owens needs to get the fuck up, man. He needs this freaking win more than Murphy does, in my opinion, but both of them need it nonetheless. No! Standing sliced bread there from Greg Murphy. About to say Greg Money. Oh, off the ropes. Elbow drop to the foot of Kevin Owens. That's very interesting. Oh, club to the back there. The big KO. And now he's got him caught. T-bone overhead toss. Release plex there from Greg Murphy. And now Murphy appears to be dragging Kevin Owens out to the center. Oh, got it. Oh, stretching out that arm, dropping the elbow across the face of Kevin Owens into the cover. One, two. Oh, we've seen Owens submit last week to Freeze. We'll see if Kevin Owens decides to give up here once he's backed up against the wall again with Gregory Murphy. I tell you, if he does that with Dean Ambrose, he is going to lose. With the role Dean Ambrose has been on as of late on NXT, dude, Kevin Owens is going to have to give it his all just like he is here tonight against Greg Murphy. Oh, once again, a counter there again. Oh, crossbody off the top from Kevin Owens into the cover. One, two. Oh, and Gold Money kicks out at two. This match has been insane, but neither of these guys want to lose this. Kevin Owens knows he's just a night away from that Ring Warriors qualifier. Oh, but you've got to think Kevin Owens has to realize if he keeps fighting here, if he makes this match last longer, it's going to weaken his chances of knocking off the Lunatic Fringe. Dean Ambrose did not have to compete the night before he has to compete in the qualifier. Kevin Owens does, because Kevin Owens is part of the Raw roster. That's the negative part of that match happening on NXT instead of Raw for Owens. Oh, Owens with a kick to the stomach as he's sending him off the ropes. Pop a powerbomb! Oh my god, and that's it, guys. One, two, three. And just like that, Kevin Owens walks out with the victory. Very emphatic statement made there from KO Kevin Owens. It was insane right here. We're going to see this again. Greg Murphy hook him. Oh, after that big move, Kevin Owens really took some shots to the head there. But you've got to think Dean Ambrose has got to be watching that with that diamond cutter and dirty deeds to his disposal. But Kevin Owens knocking heads with the referee. And right here, we're going to see KO with the cannonball avalanche style. That was insane. And then Owens would then look to follow up right here with the go-home driver to Gregory Murphy. Right here, planting him into the cover. Goes KO, one, two. Murphy was able to kick out. And then right here, we're going to see Gold Money lift him up. And watch this follow-up here. Gold Money sends Kevin Owens off the ropes. Sleeper slam to Owens. Then Gold Money quickly scurry into the cover. One, two, Owens would kick out. And then right here, of course, Owens finishing everyone with a pop-up powerbomb. Just taking out everyone just like tonight. He took out Greg Murphy. Kevin Owens making a statement for tomorrow night on NXT when he goes one-on-one in a qualifier for the Ring Warriors tournament with the Lunatic Fringe, the eccentric Dean Ambrose, who will walk out. Find out tomorrow night on NXT who will qualify. The word of mouth is going around here today is apparently Nitro and Diamond backstage earlier today had a confrontation, a physical confrontation that was. They assaulted each other backstage due to the fact that Diamond is irate after losing the belt. He doesn't even get a rematch because he didn't even defend it once. Nitro mouthing off saying at least he could hold it for a couple months. Nitro probably still a bit aggravated that Diamond pinned him for Nitro to lose the belt. Granted, it was a triple threat. Nitro never technically got his rematch that he deserved. He got a shot at a rematch, but he never actually got one, thanks to Leon Blackgrave. And that caused a fight backstage between Diamond and Nitro. I heard originally that the booking tonight was going to be Bryson Blade competing against Diamond, but now it seems as though Nitro's offering instead, which is pretty interesting. Nitro and Diamond, like I said, do not like each other. That is clear as day. Nitro and Diamond do not like each other, and they're not going to waste any time starting this match, I doubt. And here comes the former Universe Champion once again, not coming out with the jacket. He's meant a lot more business here as of late. Diamond's been a bit irate, a bit ticked off, and after losing the Universe Championship to Leon Blackgrave had a valiant performance, impressive performance by the Viking. Knocked off Nitro and Diamond in the same night to win the belt. Both these men that are in the match here tonight. And of course, after this, we'll get our first qualifier to decide who will first be the first one that actually qualifies into the Reign Warriors tournament. Like I said, these are qualifiers, not round one. These are qualifiers to get into the tournament. Tournament, of course, consists of three rounds. Round one of eight, round two of four, and then the finals. And Nitro quickly with the advantage on Diamond. Of course, the owner is going to quickly jump at an opportunity to put Nitro against Diamond one-on-one. No, especially when they're fighting in the back. Oh, went for a drop kick. Diamond ducked it. Kicked to the side. These two are going to know each other very well, even though they haven't actually competed one-on-one before, but they've competed in various tag matches, tag teamed with each other, competing in that Triple Threat Survivor Series. These two are going to know each other very well, and that's going to cause a very interesting scenario here, as you've seen. Nitro went for a dropkick, Diamond freaking ducked it. Diamond able to scout him, and now Diamond backing Nitro into the corner. Talking about a bit of fair play here, and once again, clean break between both of them. Oh, and now the cheap back elbow there from Diamond. Oh, and now Diamond with the shots to the Nitro. Diamond was able to strike first. Now he has the advantage. Oh, but you've got to know Diamond and Nitro knew each other, was going to try to cheap shot one another once they got the opportunity, and Diamond was jumped on it first. Oh, now Nitro able to counter Diamond. Nitro, of course, the veteran here. Diamond, less of a veteran, I guess you could say. Back suplex into the kip up. But he does, the records don't really show it. Diamond and Nitro, both former one-time Universe Champions. Nitro, though, of course, in the past has had all those awesome matches with GMT for the Intercontinental Championship, but never won it. Oh. But his stats won't really show that if you look at his championship reigns. Oh, now Nitro spins around Diamond. Oh, going for a combo here. 1-2. From Nitro, backbreaker into a neckbreaker. And now we've seen Diamond drop a knee a few seconds ago to Nitro. Now Nitro going to deliver one right back to him. These guys are not only going to know each other and scout each other, they're going to one-up each other at the same time as well. Or at least try to. That's going to be the goal. And straightjacket, neckbreaker there from Diamond. Getting hit with a neck breaker is bad enough, but when you get hit with it with your arms wrapped around your own goddamn throat, that's just got to be embarrassing. Diamond, of course, utilizes that move to his advantage, and now Diamond with the power game, just throwing Nitro into the corner, went to stomp him again. Nitro going to use his speed to Diamond's power. That's what's going to level off and even the playing field here. Now Nitro, oh, going vintage here. Another back suplex, and it looks like Diamond's head. He only has one. Might have bounced off the ropes there. Now Nitro looking for some vintage again. Neither one of these two qualified for the Reign Warriors tournament. They're qualified for a qualifier, which is a little too bad. None of them got drawn. Neither of these guys, I should say. Tiger suplex there from Nitro. But they're going to look to get ready for the Royal Rumble match, I would assume. Because I would assume both these men will be participants in the Royal Rumble. Of course, as I said, now the Royal Rumble going to be for the Television Championship. I heard the owner tried handing it to Superstars even in the back, but no one wants it because they all believe it's cursed. One, so of course the owner puts it on the line inside the Royal Rumble match. Therefore, you'll want to win the title because if you win it, you get to be at WrestleMania. It's a guaranteed spot at WrestleMania. Plus, you get a belt. I mean, it's a free belt. But still, then you could end up like Roman Reigns or Aztec or Draven Cross or Wicked J. We're just not going to talk about any of the rest of that. Oh, nice takedown there from Diamond. Oh, we've seen Diamond do stuff like that before. Just takes people down to the mat, just tosses them over his body. Oh, knee to the skull there. Diamond not playing around at this point. Oh, and now a nice snap down there to Nitro. Now he's got Nitro grounded. The man formerly known as the Nitro Nightmare gonna try to look to fight back into his former Universe Champion, former AWA Champion, if you will. Everyone's quote-unquote, he said it, favorite superstar, Nitro. Nitro back up to his feet. Oh, he's caught Diamond! Oh, right out of it and right into the offensive here. The speed from Nitro able to catch him into that Rana. And then right here, 6-1, Nitro into the splash. 1, 2, oh, and look how fast Nitro was able to turn it around there. He almost took the victory from Diamond there. That would have been bad for Diamond. Oh, and a Nitro cutter there to boot. Oh, God, cover. 1, 2, oh, and the former Universe Champion Diamond kicks out. Like I said, Diamond was in a grueling match with Leon Blackgrave, suffered 2 grave consequences in the match that would end up being his downfall to his title reign. Oh, and now Nitro going to snap down Diamond. Like I said, these two are going to try to one-up each other. Talk about fair play here from Nitro now, grounding Diamond down to the mat. Oh, and Diamond, though, quickly gets out of it. Oh, and it looks like a bit of a rake to the eyes there of Nitro. And now Diamond's caught him. Backbreaker! Same move he was trying to go for all night against Blackgrave. Blackgrave kept backflipping out of 1, 2. Oh, and Nitro kicks out of 2. A big vicious backbreaker from Diamond. Diamond might have the best backbreaker in the universe. Just looks like it snaps you in half. Right over the knee, 2. Answer to Anarchy! Holy shit, that's Diamond's finish there. That's Diamond's go-to finish there normally. 1, 2. Oh, and Nitro kicks out of Diamond's go-to finish. Much like Blackgrave did last night, or last weekend. Oh, now Diamond firing up, agging Nitro on. Not sure how smart that was. Nitro sends Diamond into the corner. Oh, God, now Nitro whips him into the opposite corner, running. Enzagare right to the head of Diamond, and now an elbow to the back. Nitro now using that speed, and now Nitro calling up Diamond. Oh, Nitro went to send him into the corner. Diamond counters, sends Nitro over the ropes. Oh, went for the spear. Oh, Nitro counters, boot to the goddamn skull. Oh, now Nitro going to follow up here. He's got to hurry. He wants to get anything going. Oh, wait. Oh, God, he's got Diamond on the top. Oh, Diamond, much like everyone else earlier, counters. Oh, crossbody off the top from Diamond. And now Diamond lifts up Nitro. He needs to follow up here quickly. Oh, spins him around. Oh, God, going for that kill shot. Maybe Nitro able to counter the kill shot. Oh, now Nitro with control. Backbreaker. Into the neckbreaker combo again from Nitro. Oh, and Nitro right now is tired. He needs to go for a cover possibly, but Diamond gets back up. Oh, big punt to the stomach there. Jeez. Now Nitro lifting up Diamond up to his feet. Oh God, he's going for this. Oh, the neck breaker. Oh God, that's the same move that knocked off Styles. 1, 2, 3. And now Nitro pins Diamond as well. Oh man, Diamond's got to be really frustrated now. Not only did Blackgrave pin him and make him vacate or lose his title, I should say, but now Nitro tonight on Raw just pinned him after talking smack to Diamond. Swear to God, these guys are going to send Diamond off the deep end at this point. I would have already jumped. Holy shit, freaking Nitro cutter there from Nitro, and Diamond able to kick out of it. This was a good back and forth match here. very good, intense match. Diamond there lifting Nitro back up to his feet. And then we catch him right here, this vicious backbreaker, snapping Nitro in half. You've seen the torque of Nitro's body there. Freaking almost got bent in half. And then, of course, still to come this week, we've got the huge main event on SmackDown. LAX going up against LAX challenging Crazed Chaos in a tag team street fight on SmackDown. That's going to be huge. Also, I'm sure hear from Adam Page on SmackDown as well, and possibly The Connection. And we'll have the qualifiers throughout the week on NXT and SmackDown. Appears to be finally time for the main event here in Las Vegas, Nevada. Like I said earlier, this will be the first of 8 qualifier matches to decide the lineup for the Ring Warriors tournament this year. And this man right here coming down, the leader of the Broski Club, the former runner-up for the Ring Warriors tournament from last year, the man who lost to AJ Styles in the finals at the Ring Warriors pay-per-view in the main event of Ring Warriors last year. This is none other than the Long Island Ice Z, Zack Ryder. If he hadn't went for that goddamn GMT splash off the top of a ladder instead of going for the win, I mean, he might have won the match, but stupid hurts. And let's hope that doesn't come back to backfire on him again here tonight. But he's going up against the Viking, Leon Blackgrave, the new Universe Champion. What the hell would that mean for Blackgrave? Oh, and you see Blackgrave coming down here with carrying the title in his hand. Leon Blackgrave, the new Universe Champion. Holy crap. This is insane. Blackgrave has now held the TV title and the Universe title within the span of 3 months. This is very impressive for Leon, but what does that mean for Blackgrave here if Blackgrave can qualify? What would happen if Blackgrave won the Ring Warriors tournament? Let me tell you. Let me talk to you. If he gets the win here tonight, he qualifies for the Ring Warriors tournament. If he was to go on to WrestleMania and still have the Universe Championship, well, obviously he's probably going to defend the Universe title at WrestleMania anyways. All the champions are usually booked at WrestleMania. So he would already have that match because he had the belt. So that would not count as a spot for the Ring Warriors tournament. No, he would have 2 matches at WrestleMania. What the fuck? 2 matches at WrestleMania. First person to ever do that would be for sure. He already just had 2 matches at a pay-per-view, the first person to ever do that, but let alone WrestleMania, man. How huge would that be for Blackgrave? He can make history. I'm sure he'd be sore as fuck afterwards, sore as a bitch, man. Punch right to the head. Whore's a fucking bitch on Valentine's Day, but nonetheless, lock up here again. Oh, and a clean break there between both of them. Oh, now lock up again. Two not going to waste any time. This is going to be the first of 8 qualifiers to decide who will qualify for the tournament. This is huge for one of these two guys because they get the advantage. They get the mind advantage over everyone else in the tournament because they'll get to say that they were the first person to qualify into the tournament. AJ Styles was the first one to get handpicked to be in a qualifying match, but one of these two could be the first actual qualifier into the tournament. That'll be huge for either Black Grave or Zack Ryder. Like I said, this whole Ring Warriors tournament brings in a whole new dynamic into these matches, being the fact that they are all random matchup types, which is going to be insane. We're going to have insane extreme matches possibly, or they could just be a plain normal match. That's happened before too. Oh, and huge neck breaker there from Ryder. They could get down there thinking, oh God, this is going to be a freaking tables match or something. It could just be a plain match. Oh, that's what makes these matches so interesting. Oh God, and now Tiger Bomb from Zack Ryder. What happens is I won't even know what the damn match type is either until right before the match, because the owner will tell me, but through the goddamn headset. But these guys don't know till they get in the ring and the referee tells them. It's not going to be announced. They're not going to freaking know. Side Russian leg sweep. This is what I'm sure there's a bit of luck involved with winning this tournament too, I would say. But there's going to be no luck here tonight. This is just going to be straight up skill. Whoever can get the victory here. Now Black Grave's got Ryder up. Oh God. Oh shit. The suplex tombstone. We've seen that in the past. That move is very devastating. Now Black Grave. Oh, just kicking him in the back. The Viking, the new universe champion, is looking good tonight. But now Zack Ryder. Oh, firing back in it with some shots to the face. Can't count Ryder out. Like I said, he came runner-up last year in the tournament. Sure, he'd love to be the first person to qualify this year. Oh, now Ryder right there with a counter sends, oh, Black Raven into the corner, running forearm to the face. Oh, now Ryder, where is Zack going? Zack is going to the top rope here. Oh, that was very dangerous, and Black Raven was able to chop him down. Ryder couldn't keep his balance. He fell off the top, and now Black Grave lifts him up. What is he doing? Oh, and Black Grave is going to send him crashing to the outside. That's kind of insulting. I mean, then again, Black Grave is the universe champion. I mean, he can probably get away with that. Black Grave in the past this year has had so many opportunities to get close to getting a title shot. He's fought the champs. He's went to wars with the champs, and now he's finally the champion right here on Raw. The Universe Champion. Oh, and Jesus, Ryder just went head first right into that ring post. Oh God, and Black Grave doesn't appear to be messing around, but Ryder gets back in the ring. Black Grave not going to go for any high risk like freaking, like Greg Murphy did earlier. Oh. It's too much on the line for that. Oh, now right into a dragon sleeper. Here is Black Grave. Oh, geez. Ryder. Ryder is in trouble. And clean break. Ryder there counters elbow to the face. Oh, now Ryder going to whip Leon into the corner. Back elbows to the face. And now Ryder into the cover. One count. Black Grave kicks out of one. The Universe Champion is not staying down for more than one count yet. Black Raven has always obviously got to remain focused here, because if he doesn't, Ryder's going to capitalize just like he is right now. Oh, but fully capitalize on the opportunity given and win the match. Black Raven quickly darting into cover two. Didn't figure that'd keep Ryder down. He's got to do more than that. Ryder has been kind of irrelevant as of lately. Oh. But at the end, it doesn't really matter, because, like I said, you bring it back to the stipulations of the Ring Warriors tournament and the past that Zack Ryder's had in this tournament. And now Black Raven going over a page out of the playbook of the former Intercontinental Champion, the Influence GMT. Oh, and now Black Raven was going for something, but Zack Ryder counters with a big DDT. The crowd right now firmly behind Zack Ryder. They're wanting to see Zack Ryder pull off an upset here tonight. Oh, God, and Ryder looking to do so from the middle rope. Oh, Rough Ryder. Cover. One, two, and Black Raven kicks out at two. Oh, I think Black Raven was going for that Sheen Wizard. Zack Ryder is able to stop him. Went for a drop kick in the corner. Black Raven moved out of the way. Sheen Wizard! Oh! Sheen Wizard there from Leon Black Raven. Could that be enough? He's got Ryder stunned, it looks like, or maybe even dead. One, two. Ryder kicks out of two. Ability of Ryder to pull through after that big kick to the head, or the knee of the head. It's amazing. Oh, God, and Black Raven is running. He's not wasting any time, man. He's not wasting any time. Vikings call. Oh! The Vikings call from Leon, and that could be it. One, two. Oh, and Ryder just kicked out of the Vikings call. Black Raven, the Universe Champion's got to remain composure here. He knows what he has to do. The same move that won him the belt. The same move that's been winning him all his matches. Grave consequences. He's got to remain composure and try to connect with the grave consequences. And that will be grave consequences for Zack Ryder. And his opportunity to win this Ring Warriors tournament will go out the window, and possibly his opportunity of being at WrestleMania this year again, just like last year. Gone out the opportunity, gone out the window. Oh! If he can't remain in control here somewhat and capitalize somewhere here. Oh! Oh! And Ryder with a counter. Zack with a counter, and now Zack's caught him. Oh! Another big neck breaker. Now where the hell is Ryder going? Ryder, why the hell did he go for that corner? Once again, he's fucking up. He's being stupid, just like he did last year. Oh, shit. And Black Raven has been enraged, it looks like. Leon dropping him to the middle rope. Oh, geez, what is he doing? Oh! That was an interesting move there from the Viking. Oh, and now Black Raven going to the top. He's looking to finish him here, possibly. He's looking to finish it. Elbow drop off the top. The elbow into the cover. One, two, ref, three. Well, Zack Ryder just got screwed out of the opportunity, but nonetheless, it looks like Black Raven's the first to qualify. Not how I wanted to go down, but I'm going to let it slide here. Because you see, unlike the SmackDown ref, who's just a stupid idiot, the Raw ref probably has a concussion right now after going into head-to-head with Kevin Owens earlier in the night, thanks to Greg Murphy. So Black Raven thanked Murphy on the assist there. I'm pretty sure the ref had a concussion or something. Not to see that goddamn rope break. Maybe the referees checked out. The good thing this was the main event, but nonetheless, the Universe Champion, Leon Black Raven, picks up the win here. A much more impressive start to his Universe run than he had with his TV title run, that's for sure. Right here, we're even going to get a replay of this. Right here, Leon Blackrave, insult to injury here to Zack Ryder. Going for the elbow. Oh, driving it right into Zack Ryder's chest and then right here into the cover. Hooks the leg and everything. Look, Ryder grabs the rope. The ref can easily see it. But the idiot had a concussion or something. Nonetheless, Blackrave picks up a win. He is now the first man to qualify. Tomorrow night, will it be Kevin Owens or Dean Ambrose? Will it be AJ Styles on SmackDown?